Hey guys, welcome back. So I've been thinking to do a makeup look inspired by the World Cup, since some days we've been having matches every day, so why not do a makeup to support your country? Today I'll be doing a Belgium flag inspired makeup, so I don't know if you guys are a fan of Belgium or not. Well, that's the starting point. If you want me to do another makeup look for another country, so let me know and then I'll do another video. To begin with, we're going to prepare our skin. I'm using a face moisturizer by Jolie, and it's a 24K gold infused. So you see, and I really like it because it's like you see the tiny gold particles in it, and I like to go right with my hair. As you see, it gives you a light glow just before your foundation, so that your skin doesn't look so matte. So now we're going to tackle the eye makeup, and like I told you, we're going to go with the eye makeup first and then with the face makeup. And because I have dark eye circles, I'm going to conceal that first. Here I'm using LA Girl in Pro Conceal in orange because of my blue purplish dark eye circles. And this is really pigmented, so you want to go really light with this. You see, this is really pigmented. I'm going to blend it anyway afterwards with a sponge. You could go with areas with high pigmentation in your face, like I do. I have around my lips here, so like here. And the next step is going to take a sponge and just like smudging it in your skin. I like using those triangular sponges by MAC. I'm not using a concealer right now because I have to put my foundation on and then put on the concealer so that it conceals it quite well, but just for the moment. I might go lightly on the above because it's also a bit purplish dark, just slightly. What I'll be doing right now is taking my foundation, and just for the eye area, because I'm going to work on my eye makeup, so I want it to look flawless but not my face directly if ever the eyeshadow drops. I'm using the L'Oreal Accord Parfait. It is in, it is in caramel doré, golden toffee. And this is the good one for my skin. What I'm going to do is, I'm just going to put it on my, around my eye area for the moment. Just a little bit on my hand, taking back the sponge, tap it in, so it blends, and go. As you see, it will not cover the eye area directly, and you will see the still the orange, because I'm just tapping it in, and tapping it is going to just blend it. It's not going to make it go away quickly, but that's just for the story. We're going to do it later. As yours are very sensitive areas, so don't smudge it like hard with your hands. You could go really tightly and tap it, so it's also going to circulate the blood under your eyes. This one looks better actually than this one. It looks more orange, but not a problem, not a problem at all. So for the eyes, I'm going to be doing a cut crease, and as Belgium's flag has yellow and red with it, in it, I'm going to use my Morphe 35B palette. because it really has pigmented good colors, and as you see, it's here. So the colors that I'm going to be using for this look are going to be the yellow one and the red one. I think the names are Sunshine? Yeah, Sunshine and Chicory. So we're going to start with the crease with the Chicory color, which is the red one here. And I'm going into the crease with my flat brush by Real Techniques. You see, it's already really red, and this is going to be great. We come for wins, geen tijd te verliezen. Geen wedstrijd gaan we verliezen. Naar België, we zijn hier. Het is feest, met plezier. Reus in het vat met een zwelle. We're going to blend that anyway, but for the moment, just go into the crease. And now we're going to do the other eye. This palette is amazing. I don't know why Morphe is discontinuing it. I think that maybe they're going to bring out something as good as this one, or maybe better. But I don't see them like stopping because it's like one of their best sellers. And into the colorful palettes, you have Morphe, and then you have the BH Cosmetics, which is the tropical one, I think. I don't know, something like that. So, as you see, we have a grey cut crease in red, but we're going to fade that out later. Later. The next palette that I'm going to be using to fade out that harsh line is the 88 Neutral Palette by BH Cosmetics. It is a great palette, I like it. It's one of my favorite neutral ones. BH Cosmetics are really cheap cosmetics, like very affordable cosmetics. And look at this, it's so beautiful. You have so many colors in it. So I'm taking a clean brush. It's another flat brush by Iconic. And I think I'm going into like a gold peach one, just to blend it. And we'll stay in the matte colors. So a gold peach one, I guess this one here is a very, this one here is a very good transition for the red and into the brow bone. We're going to take it with a clean brush, and we're going to smudge it out. You don't want any harsh lines because it doesn't look good. It's still a harsh line, but we can do it. As I have a really half slightly hooded lids and small, so I can't really blend all of it, or else the red is gonna go away. And always take a clean brush for blending, because the same brush is just going to make the red go really above, and that's going to be so pigmented, so that's not going to be nice. There, I think that's quite a blend. And what I'm going to do now, to have a perfect cut crease, I'm going to take a flat brush, a small flat brush, and put concealer on my lids. So again, I'm going with a Real Techniques small brush, the really small one, and my NARS concealer. This one is in caramel, I think. No, it's in ginger, medium too. And what I do is I hate spending makeup. Yeah, so what I do is I take like the concealer that stays in here, because sometimes there's a very good quantity and you can't use it. So with a brush, you see, you get it right directly, and I use this to conceal because it's easy and I can use my makeup much longer. So we're going into the crease right now. Now One thing that you can do is when you're looking down, you just put a slight above and you look up. And you're going to see directly the line that creates up here, and that's going to be your cut crease. What I also like to do sometimes is take a makeup remover cloth and just remove it so that the concealer doesn't get blended with their eyeshadow, because sometimes it's dark and then it doesn't go away, but in this case we can go directly with it. So let's go. That's kinda okay. We're going to darken it much later. We're going to do the other eye now. Yes, I know, I do look awkward with the orange around my mouth, but don't worry, it's gonna go away in a few minutes. I'm just going in again with the concealer here so that I create this really crease, because I don't want to see a basket crease. I'm just going up a bit because I don't have makeup here, and I'm just going to blend it with my brush. It looks kinda okay, I think. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to fix it with powder so that it doesn't stamp on my lids when I look above or right in front, because you know, it's concealer, it's liquid. I'm just taking a normal powder that I bought from Basta Cosmetics, and I'm just going to set it in. I'm using a small fluffy brush because it's a small area and I don't want powder everywhere before I put the foundation, so I'm just going to fix it in. Don't worry, Sona, it's also going to be... I forgot the primer, but okay, it's okay. So you see it gives like a small subtle look to it. And also powder will mattify the area and make the other color that's going to be put on it, which is going to be yellow here, stay put. So now that it's set, we're going to go again with red and create that cut crease a bit sharper, because as you see, the color blended a bit in. I want to give it a good red. I don't know if I'll maybe mix it with another color, we're just going to see. So I'm taking the chicory again with a flat brush, and I'm going to sharpen this area. You see, you already have a better cut crease. I'll be adding a bit of brown to it so that it could get a deeper red, because I think it's getting a bit like a pinkish red here, and I want it to be more red. So I'm going back to my BH palette and I'm going into... I don't know. So I didn't go into brown one, I did go into like a light black here, and I'm going in very lightly because I don't want it to be black, I want it to keep the red. What do you think? It's nice, right? I like it. Now we're going to do the next eye. The next step is using a yellow one. It's going to be the yellow one I was talking about from the Morphe palette, the Sunshine one, which is a really yellow one. I'm hesitating into going in with my hands or with my fingers, actually. Don't use the same brush because it has red in it. And if you use yellow, it's not going to be yellow. It's going to be orange. So we're going to go with a clean brush. Where did I put it? So I'm taking an iconic brush, a flat brush. Well, it's an angle brush, but it's going to work out just to get a yellow on it. And as you see, it's very pigmented. Just tap it in so that you don't get, you see that? So that you don't get any excess falling off your face. If you do, it doesn't matter. But here, so you see, that's really subtle. That's why I didn't want to use a brush. I go in with my fingers. So it is more intense than the other one, but still could be more. And I think that's a mistake of mine. I should have used a primer. So it's going to make the colors look more pigmented. But it's okay. I was actually so excited to do this makeup look so that I forget about it. I'm sure it happens to you guys, like you so want to try a makeup product that you just bought, and then when you realize that you have to go really quickly to a function, to a party or anything, so you forget about it and then you're like, oh shit, I didn't try it, sorry. That's the first time I put on yellow eyeshadow and it doesn't look like a sick person. So that's great. We're going to pose the eye makeup for the moment because we aren't going to use any more eyeshadow like really, really up on it. We're going to work on the face makeup right now. So I'm going back to my foundation. And I'm going to put it into my hand. That's not really sanitary or hygienic, but you know. What I'm also gonna do is I'm going to add a little drops of Iconic Illuminator. This one is in original and it's again just to give that light glow, not to look so dull. And as you see, it's very shiny. And I'm just going to add small drops to the foundation because this illuminator is really, really dense. So I mix it up into my foundation. I don't know if you see it. Never mind. And I'm going with my foundation brush by Real Techniques. And I'll be going into my face. So I also don't like to feel that there is foundation on my face, so I go on really lightly. And I take this buffing brush from Real Techniques and I just buff it in to give a natural look to it. So that it doesn't look cakey. I don't like cakey makeups. See, you have the glow though, and this is what the illuminator does. I like it. I don't like putting it on my face directly. Go away. because it's so, like I showed you, it's so pigmented. So again, with the buffing brush, I'm going to go through the makeup, through the foundation. You see, all the orange has gone and I have like a glowy skin. I mean, I had a glowy skin. And as you see, I haven't used much foundation, it's just very light. Now we're going to go with the concealer, and apply it on the dark circles here so that it looks kind of fresh. One little tip is from Wayne Goss, the makeup artist. I don't go with the triangle, I just go lightly in here and in here. Why? Because you just need a little makeup to cover up your dark circles. So what I do is take out my triangular brush, my triangular sponge again, and just blend it. See? I don't like much makeup, and this technique is awesome. Because the concealer is just going to blend with your foundation and you don't really need much to do it. So the Belgian flag has black, yellow and red. Now we're going to go with the black one. Here, for the eyeliner, I'm using the Elamasca Prestige Gel Liner in Infinity, which is a very dark black. I just love this gel liner because it's so long lasting, it's waterproof. It's the best. As you see, I use it almost every day. Every time I need to use an eyeliner, that's my go-to eyeliner. To look precise? Yeah. My mirror is so far away from me because I need both of my hands to do it. And I'm trying to do my best. I can't! Ah! Okay, I just tried doing it. My lashes are getting in the way. Come on, guys. Don't make this difficult for me. What you want to do is to keep a little bit of space here to add the yellow one. Here! It does look nice, right? Now we're going to do the other eye, same thing. To make the yellow look out more, I'm going to try like wet application and see if it works. So I'm going with a flat brush again. I'm just going to dampen the brush a bit and go back into the yellow tone and try to see if it's gonna work. I don't know if the Morphe palette is could be a wet application. I just don't want to spoil it. So let's just try it. I think it does get on nice. You see this one and this one. This one is highly more pigmented, like really lightly. But then with the camera and in real it looks more yellow and... it's great. So now you could just line it up a bit here. Nice. Do the same for the other eye. Next, I'm going to line my waterline with a black color to give my eyes a better shape. And the pencil collection by Morphe, which is in bold. So it's like pen pencils for both your eyes and your lips. So you can see these are the colors that I have in here. And today I'm going to use the black one, the dark room, to line my waterline. And I'm going to use Mina, which is the red one, for that special touch. So this is the dark room and I'm going in my waterline. After the dark room, we're going to go with the Mina. Like I said, it's Mina, it's red, and we're going to go under the eye with it to give a little bit of that red touch. It's so effing difficult when you have to use both your hands and I'm not getting in position to put on my mirror, so I'm just going lightly beneath it, because I could add a yellow line again here, and just not so down, because you know, red, I have like a bronze skin, I mean like a brown skin, but people, if you're really fair and you go so much down, it's going to look like you're sick or you have a runny nose and everything. So just go on really light with the red color. Looks good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to that sunshine yellow color from the Morphe 35B palette, and I'm just going to fill in the little line here with the same brush. Okay, you don't quite see it, but it's here. You could go with a touch of glitter if you wanted to. So here, we are almost done for the eyelashes. I really love the big black mascara by Pastel Cosmetics. It is a brand from Turkey, I think. And you see, it really has small bristles, which are great for the eyelashes. I'm not going to put on any fake lashes here. I am going on with my natural ones. Aye. Oh, good. I don't know. You tell me. What do you think? Oh, I didn't do my brows. I'm just so not used to doing my brows, but here, like, it's like an intense makeup, so you'd like to give a little bit of color to my makeup brows. And for my brows, I'm using the brow kit by e.l.f. I think it is in dark. Yeah, it is in dark. And what I do is I just use the small brush that they put it in. I like it. It's really handy. And I take the angle brush and I take like the dark color here, and I'm just going to lightly give it some color. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm going to contour my face. So I'm going to use Illumisca Gel Sculpt in Silhouette. I think it's the darkest they have, and I love this contour because it has a very smooth finish. This is the color, and it smells so good. What I do contour is my nose a bit. I don't go in into my jawline because I think I have already a thin face and it doesn't look that great. I'm just going lightly with my jawline. So I already have like a line here. I'm just going to go right lightly through it. I like to correct a bit here because I fell when I was a child, so. And refining the jawline here. Let's blend it, because having harsh lines like this is not beautiful. I'm taking the stippling brush again, and I'm just gonna tap it in so that it does blend into the foundation. That's the sun, which is actually going on my face, so you see like the highlight. I'm using a normal blush by Pastel Cosmetics, again the Turkish brand of makeup, and this one is in 6. I like it because it's a very pale pink and it has like tiny little gold in it, so it gives like a dewy finish. In here I'm taking the blush brush by Real Techniques and I'll be going lightly onto my cheeks. I like this brush because it doesn't take much blush, so even if you have like a heavy hand and you went into your blush like really very much, so it's not going to go like a real pink one, it's going to go very lightly. It's a very smooth brush. For a highlight, I'm using the White Gold by City Color Illuminator, and it comes in a tiny pot. And I love this. It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. I apply it every time with my hand. So you see, it's like a white gold like this. And what I do is I just tap it in here. I don't go in here because I do have some dark circles. And if I go into my illuminator or my highlighter in it, it's going to show more my dark circles actually. I just go in with my fingers and I just blend it into my foundation and into my brush. Do you see that? Here there's nothing. It's just the iconic that I use on my foundation and this is the highlighter. Damn it. And this is a very good tip for applying your highlighter. I am actually just in natural sunlight here. And you see directly where light is going onto your face. So you see the light goes on my nose here, a bit above my eyebrow, and on my cheeks. So what happens is I would apply highlighter on those areas. This is so gorgeous. She puts her mouth on a cigarette. I put it out cause she likes that. She always dances when it's raining. And it's great. She wants somebody to love, to hold her. She wants somebody to love in the right way, in the right way, in the right way, in the right way, in the right way. Looks good. For the lips, you could go really crazy, like the Belgian flag on your lips, like black, yellow, and red, just to make it fun. But as I have to go on with my day, I'm going to keep a classic look, so I'm going with a red lipstick here. In my case, because I want it to be long-lasting all day, I'm using the Focal U one in Coquelicot, the number one, which is the red one, the classic red one. And I just love this lipstick. It lasts a whole day long, even when I eat and everything. It doesn't budge. And as you see, I have like half of it left because I use it so much. So here I'm going to take a lip brush, just a normal lip brush. I got this in a gift when I bought some makeup products. and I'm going to go with the red lipstick. You see, it's a liquid one. It smells like chocolate and sugar. And it's a matte one, so I'm just going to fix all this because it has to stay till the night. And even if you're going to jump up and down as your team is going to win, you're going to want to fix it. So here in this case, I'm using the Dewy Finish by NYX. And I just like shaking it a bit and like resistance. Just so you know, it won't move. So girls, tell me what you think of this look, if you like it, and if you're going to recreate this look, tag me in it on Instagram. My Instagram handle is down below, or after the video you're going to see all my handles here, and also hashtag ZHairInspired, so that I'm going to see your recreation of this look. And if you want me to do another makeup look for another World Cup team, whatever country it may be, I'm going to do it for you so that you can support your team. So girls and guys, I hope that you like this very much. If you did, you know what to do, like my video and subscribe for more. And also don't forget that bell near the subscribe, like here. Just click on it because you're going to get notified as soon as I post a video. Thank you so much. I'm loving myself. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you like it. Until next time, bye bye.